What is up, YouTube? Welcome back to channel. Hope you guys have an amazing day so far. Like always, if you're new to channel, I want you guys to hit the thumbs up and only $5 value to you guys through this video. Who ended the video? I want you guys to subscribe icon. To play Battlefield 2042 at the best performance possible. Now, this is some of the settings that I've taken some of the pro players, or some of the settings that I've been having for years in all Battlefield games, as well as Apex Legend, where I play, you know, full time. So right off the bat, we're gonna start with the general settings. Now, the only thing I did touch on here was mostly the aircraft vertical look inverse. So usually this is on, which pretty much means that if you're trying to go up, you have to press down. If you're trying to go down, you need to press up. So I've switched it back to normal, which means that if I want to go up, I just press up. So that's one thing that's based on your preferences. If you're used to playing, you know, with control or even mouse and have it as inverted, then keep it inverted. I personally switched it back to normal. So that's pretty much it for the general aspect. Now for the display, this really depends on what type of computer you have. It really depends on what type of monitor you have. Now I am playing on a 2040 hertz monitor, so this is why it's naturally set up like this, as well as pretty much like a lot of these things are on a little bit on high, but we'll talk about that a little bit next. The next thing would be the field of view. Now this is something that there's quite a bit of debate about. Mostly the key here is, if for you that's just starting, I'll say start with the 80 at the very bare minimum, and then increase it to possibly 90 to maybe 100, deciding whether or not you want to have that type of display. So what a field of view means is that you're able to see a little bit closer, or things is going to be a little bit closer, slash you're going to be able to see things a little bit smaller in a sense. So if you're sniping, you might consider having an 80 field of view, and if you're just kind of like an assault and you're trying to go rush in one-on-one type of fights, you definitely want to have it around the 105, 100, because everything's going to seem a lot closer and you're going to be able to focus on that one target. So this is really something that depends on your preferences. I always play with 105, even with snipers, because even on scoping down range, 105 seems a lot closer. Now the vehicle third person field of view, you definitely want to have that at I-88, because whenever you go in third person point of view for the vehicles, you want to be able to see all around you while you're on the tank or anything like that, in case enemies trying to, you know, creep up to you and put C4 on your tank and blow you up. So now the brightness, this is something I always have it at 60. It really depends on your computer slash monitor. I just prefer to have it a little bit brighter, and I always put it at 60. The graphics and stuff like that, this is where a lot of streamers and a lot of different individuals will tell you to put it on low, so you'll be able to see, to have increased FPS and ultimately see people a little bit further down. Now I have it everything on high. I do have a pretty high graphic card, so it really depends on your computer and what your performance is. So I will start with high, and then depending on the quality, because mostly I stream half of the time, I might reduce it down to medium to low, depending on which one I prefer here. Now I do have the DLS to ultra performance, because obviously I want to make sure that it looks really good in stream. So that's one of my key here, but that is all preferences, and that really depends on you. Now the HUD, I did not touch any of this, but this is pretty much where you can find the colorblind aspect. So if you are colorblind, you can adjust all this in this setting right here. Now the crosshair, this is where I actually made a lot of my modifications here, which is the crosshair thickness. I put it in thick from, you know, default. And then obviously I'm in my crosshair kind of reddish pinkish, mostly because I'm someone that always looks down the range on the weapon and not so much as to where the crosshair is, which is kind of a pain for most part. So I decided to make it red so it'd be more noticeable. Now the hit marker color, which is going to be, you know, white like everybody else has. The headshots, I did switch that to red so I know when I'm hitting headshots. And then the kill color is going to be black. Now the armor hit calculator, which I'm not... When it comes down to armor, it's not everybody has one, but whenever you get some, it's pretty much going to be blue, like, you know, Apex is for most part. So the mini map, the only thing I really did here was pretty much kind of like take off the whole rotation view. I'm personally somebody that do not like have seen the mini map running around. Like, I just like it in one spot. I don't like to just look at that one spot the entire time, but that's about it. That's why I turned that off, and it just kind of keeps just the mini map in one single location. Now the sound, not gonna go over this, it really depends on you. Controller, now this is something that down the road I will be doing a video on, a very detailed aspect, so make sure you guys go in the comment section, let me know if there's something that you're interested in, because I pretty much, whenever I play Apex, I pretty much have no recoil with my controller, so because of the settings that I do have. So this is something that you can play with it in here. Now, this game in particular, I will be playing with mouse and keyboard, but I will be doing some controller gameplay as well whenever I go live or do some other things. But controllers, you have to play with the axle and dead zone and a few other things in order for you to kind of reduce the recoil, because mouse and keyboard recoil is probably a lot less than it is with controller. So it really comes down to, whether or not you want to take off your aim assist and really just kind of focus on your own particular skill. That is something that I like to do. So next thing you have is the mouse and keyboard. Obviously, this is something that I'm going to keep about the same here. But the foot, obviously, this is like the basic setting, which is 20 sensitivity. I'm trying to learn to kind of like keep it at a 20 sensitivity. I'm not trying to go too high, or I might go a little bit less depending on what my skill set is and how hard it is for me to control it. But other than that, it's pretty much everything else is the same. I didn't touch any of this yet. Vehicles, same thing, but I'm not going to go too much in details here. Everything else from here on out is really just kind of like things for you, in a sense. Now, I did reduce completely the motion blur. I completely took that out. You don't want to have too much blur in your camera and whatever else. And I also reduced the camera shake amount completely out, because, for example, whenever you get blown up and you're near a tank or there's an explosion, or even whenever the map, has a hurricane, you're gonna have a lot of shaking within the screen, and it's very hard for you to aim. So I decided to kind of take those two out because it will help me, be able to shoot someone when I'm in the middle of a tornado or something like that. So this is where you're gonna be using the key binding for, all the mouse and keyboard aspect of things. The only thing I would say probably look into is whether or not you want E to interact with things, and then obviously what the melee thing's gonna be. Now, Foxtrap is probably not gonna be my melee one. I'm probably gonna switch this to 5 because everything else is 1, 2, 3, 4. There's no 5s in here, so I probably will be switching that to 5. But other than that, everything else is pretty much gonna stay the same when it comes to everything else. We'll be creating a server for Battlefield 2042. So if you guys, those of you that are coming in and are new to my channel, make sure you hit the like and hit the subscribe and, tag that notification bell so you get notified as soon as I go live. But I will be creating a server for 2042 where I will be doing a hardcore large conquest mode as soon as I'm able to, because there's already a lot of servers open apparently, and I'm not able to create one right now. But as soon as I'm able to, I'm gonna invite each and every single one of you guys both to the Discord as well as to the actual game itself, and you'll be able to play with me as well as other streamers as well. So thank you all so much for following. Thank you all so much for every single like and subscribes, and I'll see you guys next time.